Hello, and welcome once again to the Dental Marketing Mastery Series. This podcast is brought to you by dentalwebcontent.com and New Patients Incorporated. I'm Howie Horrocks, the founder of New Patients Incorporated. Along with me once again is my friend and partner and the president of New Patients Incorporated, Mark Dilatush.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to our second podcast of the new year. I've got my good buddy Mark Dilatush on the other end of the line. How you doing, Mark?
Good. Hey, let me ask you a question. As we did, you said this was our first of the new year, and this is the second.
Yeah, it is.
Are we going to go through all the way to 52? Right.
No.
Hi, everybody. This is our 52nd podcast, 2017.
No, you'll never hear another word about it.
I'm just teasing. Go ahead.
Anyway, I thought what we might want to look at is the subject of video and how a dentist can make use of it in his or her dental practice and all the various forms and shapes that video might take. What do you think? Think that's a good topic?
Yeah, I think it's an awesome topic. I think it's actually an underused media type. I really do. I mean, it's there's several different kinds of video. I mean, let's do this. Let's just identify the different kinds.
Okay, I've got one.
Yeah, right?
On your homepage of your website.
Yeah, there you go. That's a great. So let's go through the homepage website video. And what should the content of that be? Should that be a bloody implant surgical site video?
Oh, yeah.
No, it's not. No, the first thing that you need to do with your website visitors, the first thing you need to do with any advertising is to establish an elevated level of trust and respect.
Right.
And video does that better than a picture, better than a bio, better than a written word. Wouldn't you agree, Howie?
Yeah, and that's precisely the reason we started filming our clients, 10 years ago, and just for that reason. I mean, you can only do so much with photos and words. You can do a lot with photos and words. But to establish a level of familiarity and trust with the person who, which is usually a woman, who lands on your website, that takes video. They want to meet you. They want to see you and understand what kind of person you are.
Right. So that's video. Yeah. So one of the keys that you would take away from that is, if you are going to create a homepage video, create one of the dentists introducing themselves and welcoming the visitor traffic to their website.
Exactly.
Another thing you might glean from this conversation is, don't bury the video under "our team, meet the dentist, are you sure?" Okay.
Yeah.
Put the video right on your homepage.
Exactly. Now, that's not to say you can't have a Meet the Doctor team video on that page, too. That's fine.
Of course.
The second most visited page of any dental website is the Meet the Team page.
But don't hide the dentist intro video. That's my point.
Exactly.
Right. Put it on your homepage. And it'll be very interesting after you do. You're going to look at your Google Analytics, and you're going to see how many visitors versus how many people watch that video, and those numbers are going to be very close together. Okay, especially the number of new visitors to your website who also watch that video. Right. If you have 100 of those who come to your website, 98 of them are going to watch that video.
Yeah, that's what mom wants to find out. You know, she's going to considering turning over her kids, her husband, and herself to a medical practitioner here, and she want, you know, and then there's going to be sharp instruments involved, and there's going to be all kinds of things involved. Yeah. She wants to get a good look at you.
Exactly. And for our listeners out there who may have last names that could be confused with someone not from the U.S., this is important. If your name is Dabila Botswani, Dr. Dabila Botswani, I just made that name up, okay? But as a human being, as a dental consumer, you wonder if you can communicate with someone with that name. Don't you, Howie?
Yeah.
Okay. Dr. Dabila Botswani may be from America, may have been educated in America, may speak absolutely 100 perfectly understandable English, and probably knows more English than you and I combined. Okay. But the dental consumer would never know that if all they saw was the name.
Exactly.
See what I mean? Right? Yeah. So the more foreign, here's my point, the more foreign your name sounds, even though if it does, obviously doesn't sound foreign to you, okay? But the more it would sound foreign to a dental consumer, the more you need that homepage video to allow them to see if they can communicate with you.
Yeah, it has nothing to do with anything racial. It's simply a communications issue.
Right.
And we found that out many, many years ago to our good cheer that it had nothing to do with that. It was purely, can I understand him or her, and can they understand me?
Exactly. So that's a homepage video. Should they have about a minute and a half, or should it be an hour long so that they can talk about all the CE they've taken for the last 20 seconds?
Let me see. Well, what's the correct answer to that?
Yeah. No, obviously the answer is about a minute and a half.
Max.
And Howie, you're the one who writes all the scripts and all the words for all the work that we do for our clients. So I defer to you. Really, how much can you say, right?
Yeah.
A minute and a half.
Yeah, you know, it's the same problem you have when you're composing a radio spot or TV spot. It's the real estate. You know, you can't tell the whole story of the practice in a minute and a half or 90 seconds, or 60 seconds. You can't.
Right.
So don't try.
Right. Well, what can you communicate?
What you can communicate is that you are there, you're welcoming new patients, including them, the one who just landed on your site, and that there are a few key marketable attributes that we have that you may not fully grasp right away, but here they are, and you can go down and mention two or three and mention that you're very insurance friendly. And, you know, you're right across the street from the post office and the entire family is welcome. And, you know, look around and call us if you have any questions, that kind of a thing.
Right. You know? That kind of a thing. Right. Or you may have great hours. Right.
Yeah.
Basically, the bottom line is in the intro video, when you script it, you prioritize the script based on your priority marketable attributes.
Exactly.
So one might be a service, one might be a convenience, one might be price, one might be technology. You got four things to talk about. You hit the entire gamut. For those of you listening to this, if you go to our website, to our resources, there's free downloads. There's a marketable attribute scorecard. The scorecard will tell you what matters most and least to the consumers. Go ahead. It's free. It doesn't cost anything. So you can script your video that way. Talk about those three or four things. Well, what else could you possibly, what if you could schedule on your website? What if the patients could actually schedule their appointment on your website? You might want to include that in your video.
Mm-hmm.
You might want to reference the 146 great Google reviews you have that are sitting on your website as well.
Yes.
So all those things can be done in about 60 to 90 seconds. And then that's all you need, right? As long as I can meet the dentist, see that they're just a regular human being, I can communicate with them. They look understanding. They look like they'll listen to me.
Mm-hmm. Right? Yeah.
They're non-threatening.
Right. And then further, if the consumer is looking for a specific service or to solve a specific problem, like, you know, her
loose
husband's.
Dentures.
Yeah, loose dentures, for example. So, you know, and it just so happens that implants is a very marketable attribute, according to the Marketable Attribute Scorecard. Mm-hmm. So she might click on that video and or that page of your website, and pops Dr. Jones again, explaining all the wonderful things that they can do with implants and implant-supported dentures and that sort of thing. So you have a video on each page. You don't have to have it. You can overdo this. You don't want 57 videos necessarily, but you want one or each marketable attribute page that you have on your site, right, Mark?
Yeah, absolutely. That's why when you go to our sites, you're going to see those priority marketable attributes are on a page of their own.
Yeah.
We don't put all the marketable attributes in a 12-foot scroll.
Yeah, no.
So,
all right. Well,
so that's one way to use video.
Yeah. What are some other ways?
We have, one of the most common ways. I'm sorry, Hallie. Go ahead.
No, that's okay. I was just going to say we can. There are multiple uses for video. Go ahead.
Yeah, I think the next most common is having a what I call a silent video on a flat screen on the wall facing the chairs for of the patients who are seated, and maybe they're waiting 90 seconds, right, for their appointment.
Right, no more than.
Well, nobody listening to this podcast ever lets any of their patients wait in the reception area,
yeah,
right?
No, but just in case.
Just in case, okay. Obviously, we're being facetious. But this is a wonderful, wonderful opportunity. You are subliminally communicating at us. Basically, it's a slideshow. Let's say 7, 8, 9, or 10, somewhere in there, of your most prominent marketable attributes, the ones that are the highest scoring on those score sheets. Mix it up. Technology, services, conveniences, price. Mix it up. Have two of these pages slides for each one of those, and then just loop them through without sound. It's just silent. And a slide comes up, did you know? Slide comes up, did you know? Slide comes up, did you know? And I'm sitting there waiting for my dental appointment and go, you know what? I didn't know.
Yeah.
My mom has just last week, my mom was complaining about her slipping dentures, and I see this slide comes up, goes, did you know we can fix slipping dentures? Well, no, I didn't know. Thanks for telling me. Right.
So
when I go into the operatory for my appointment, I'm going to go talk to the doctor about my mom who was complaining last weekend about her slipping dentures, because you know what? I didn't know.
Right.
And you know why I didn't know? Because nobody ever told me. Until exactly. I sat in your reception room.
and that could be true of a patient that's been a member of the practice for 10 years.
Absolutely.
We're not just talking about new patients here.
No.
I had no idea the doc could help my husband out with his snoring.
Yeah, there's another one. I mean, there's another one. It's kind of obvious, right? So I talked to a dentist, and they say, well, you know, what do you think about veneers? Dennis smiles, of course. I love veneers, right?
Yeah.
It's like, now, what do you like about veneers? You know, and I know what they like about veneers. They're fairly easy, fairly predictable, high margin dental services. And the dentist, what dentists really like about it is the change in the patient's face once they smile for the first time when they see their veneers, right?
Yeah,
the wow factor, right? If you talk to, yeah, if you really study this out, that's dentists love that, right?
Yep.
Well, what if you had a slide that says we can fix gaps in your teeth without orthodontics?
Yeah.
Huh. I did not know that, right?
Right. So, or I did not know that my doc did that.
Right. There you go. All right. I did not know that my doctor did that. And you don't have to call yourself the almighty cosmetic dentist. You're just a dentist that fixed gaps in teeth without ortho.
Yeah.
Right? So anyway, so another use of a great use of video, very inexpensive to produce, would be a flat screen in your reception room. You can use them in your operatory computers as screensavers as well if you want. That's fine. But anyway, it's just very low key, very ultra professional, totally subliminal. Okay. But you'll see the difference. You know, patients are going to come up to you and go, you know, what about this thing I saw? And you're going to recognize where they saw it, right? So that's another use of video. I think that's the most common, I think, is on the website. I think the second most common is in the reception area. And I think the next building momentum use of video is on social media. And you can use your intro video on your website on social media. You can use segments of your reception room video for social media. What we have found is the animated videos work really, really well for communicating the benefits of dentistry to a general audience. Animated videos are, you may have seen them on commercials with the hand drawing things or writing words out, or maybe characters with a voiceover and they're talking about certain subjects. That's what an animated video is. They have proven to communicate general topics to the general audience really, really well. And dentists like it because what we found when we were filming dentists is about 50% of them are really good in front of the camera and 50% of them are absolutely terrible in front of the camera. Okay. So the dentists who aren't so good in front of the camera, you're probably never going to coach them into being good. Right. But you don't want them to lose out on this video craze. So that's really where the animated videos come in. They communicate the benefits of the dentistry you provide without you having to be in the video. Right.
Yeah.
So you brand the front of it to your office, you brand the back of it to your office, you have a centralized message about a single topic about dentistry, and it could be anything. It could be your insurance policies, it could be Halloween candy buyback, it could be dental implants, could be sleep apnea, it could be any subject you want, right? And these are about, you know, 40 to 60, maybe 70 seconds long, right? So when you do post them on your social media, they get watched, they get liked, they get shared, which is really what you're trying to do. Okay. So, that's a growing section of the overall topic, video. You know, we have a whole, I don't know how many we have on dental web content now, Howie, probably 500.
Oh, I would say at least,
yeah. I'd say at least 500 of these,
producing more every day.
Yeah, we're cranking them out. So dental web content is a subscription based website where it's a low monthly subscription. You can go in there and get any content you want on any subject about dentistry you want at any time you want. It's on demand. So those animated web videos are very, very popular with the subscribers on our dental web content site. So video. Is there anything else that you can think of that we use video for, Howie?
Well, I wanted to make a note. You know, we've been flying our clients out to our film studio here in Vegas for many years, and the reason that we do that is so that we can control the quality.
Oh yeah.
You know, we've got million freaking dollars in that film studio, and we do that just so we can control the quality and the sound and you know, the brightness, and everything has to be just right. Now if you're a dentist who's going to take a video or have somebody use their phone to take a video, I mean, we're not saying don't do that, but we're saying you have to pay attention to the quality, because a badly done video can actually drive people away. So
yeah,
keep that in mind.
Well, yeah, I'm gonna say, I think the scripting is as important as the video quality. I really do. Yeah. I mean, wow, we've seen some really, really head shakers, you know, videos on homepages on web dental websites. You can absolutely grab an iPhone and take a video. Everybody can. Just be very careful of what you're saying. Be careful of what you're saying, how long you're saying it, or how long the entire video is, and which subject you're talking about. So that's why we said at the very beginning, just download the marketable attributes sheet, check off the marketable attributes that you possess and that score the highest on the sheet. Make sure you grab one or two out of each category, and that basically becomes the beginning of your scripting. And then just write down your words, practice your words, and then let somebody take a video with an iPhone, right? That's okay, right? Yeah. So anyway, that's video.
Yeah, there you go. That was fun.
Snappy close, Howie.
Well, you know what, Mark? We just found out that, we have some clients in foreign countries that have been listening to our podcast. So we're very grateful that we have a growing audience out there. And we thank all of our listeners for tuning in. And, we'll see you again soon here, real soon. Thank you.
We hope you've enjoyed our podcast today. You can find more podcasts on our YouTube channel, on Stitcher, and iTunes. Also on our websites, dentalwebcontent.com and newpatientsinc.com.